Hey y'all, this is Spencer from True Time, and here we are again. This time we're solo, heading into a spot. We're hoping to cash in on a mule deer this week. I'm loaded down right now. I got 7 liters of water on me. I'm hoping to do where I'm going right now, like 2 nights. But that could change. And it could just be too hot, and I might just have to hope for the best. But probably wait it out and just early mornings, late nights, right? First light and last light. Hope for the best. One of the hardest parts about hunting that I find is coming up with a game plan. And when you start second guessing where you want to go, what you want to do, it gets hard. I'm right now torn between pushing really far or staying sort of in this area. Where my dog's hair everywhere. I just ended up jumping something from its bed. I must have been like 20 yards from it. This hillside is so overgrown. Hiking across these logs. There's sign everywhere. Everywhere. New, old. Deer, bear, every single animal that inhabits this terrain or this area. Such a gnarly spot. Just grabbing that log to get over it. It's pretty awesome. was like right below my camp. I was about to do that thing with that really thick stuff. And I purposely was like, okay, I'm gonna push towards the open. And I'm pretty sure I pushed that deer out of that timber into the opening. And that was what was bedded in the timber there. And yeah, I blew it. I saw the rack. And I was like, whoa, crazy. Thinking it was just gonna stand there forever. Of course it's not. Mature mule deer do not just stand there forever. As soon as they figure out what you are or what you aren't, they take off. I just started moving, and that was a mistake. I should have waited like 5 seconds at least. I would have known where he was after he moved over the scene. But I panicked and got buck fever. It's nice here though. Kind of been shuffling around this morning, just kind of looking at different spots and looking far away, and I spotted something like probably about 2 kilometers away, way up on this ridge. It just got hit by the sun, so it was really noticeable. Was on it for about 5 seconds and then walked right into the bush after. Just turned around and walked into the thick stuff. It looked, based off of how light it was, it looked like it was a deer. blows. Broke the tripod off the head of the tripod. So I'm gonna have to come up with something. Jimmy rig it. This country is ridiculous. It's just deadfall everywhere. Just picked up camp. I'm gonna try and push to the outline. It's kind of gonna be play it by ear. If it just seems a little bit hairy, because it's not actually a trail. It's just a ridge that's like 2 kilometers. So if it's ridiculous, then I'll probably turn around.
At this point, I was trying to get the moose to come in, but he just wouldn't push past that timber line. You can faintly hear the bull grunt as he comes to the edge of the thicket.
Responded to the first one, and then I think he must have just caught my wind. I thought that would be cool if he came in though. That would be awesome footage. It's too bad. Decided to pull out going into the alpine. That whole moose ordeal kind of stunted the process, because no, I don't think I have enough time. I mean, I probably do if I just like push for it, but I don't even know where I'm going, so I kind of want like, I want like at least 5 hours to get there. I'm gonna have to get a tightrope, man. Put the pack on, do some tightrope. How many logs I've walked across? Just got to a new camp spot, and I'm gonna sleep beside a deer bed. Sweet. Forgot to mention I got a grouse. That's a bull. Hey, bull. Hey, moose. They're so horny right now, these bulls. This is crazy. I can't believe it came in. I had music playing. Just work my way up onto this little knoll here for first light. Well, I'm a little late, but I didn't know how long it was gonna take me to get here. Not a lot of high hopes right now. It's just too hot. Now that I'm at lower elevation, I'm kind of noticing, I don't think, I'm going to have much luck seeing anything in here unless I'm bumping them out of their beds. Yeah, I'm kind of stumped right now. It's not cold enough. The weather is, like, super nice. It's super calm. But I need the perfect scenario, basically. I mean, there is no such thing as the perfect scenario, but I need to set myself up a little bit better here. Just not in this, I was kind of hoping that this spot was going to be okay, but it's just not a great spot for right now. This spot's gonna be good in like November. Got myself in this hole. Man. So I decided to post up and take it kind of easy tonight. Put a lot of miles on the boots, so just kind of giving myself a break from the hiking tonight. Decided to switch up my style of hunting. I'm gonna start still hunting through some timber. I think it's honestly the best bet I got because I don't think anything's moving. So let's do a little bit of bush stalking. Walked through a nice patch of timber there, found some nice natural openings, and some fairly fresh sign. Oh, there's a grouse. It's a good sized grouse. Wish I had a grouse gun. A little calm before the storm, so once the weather pushes in, I'm gonna work my way up onto the top of this ridge that I'm parked right below. I'm gonna camp there for tomorrow night. Two does feeding just on the hillside above me. It's crazy. I was walking out to get wood, and then I heard a couple of cracks. I'm like, what the heck? And like way up the hillside, I saw these three deer come. I don't know where the third one went, but the two were just, they just hung out. It looked like they got spooked by something.